personal outcry. I'm 20 years old and I'm from Odisha. Currently, I'm pursuing my graduation from Delhi University. I love reading. Reading inspires me to write. And that's how I am here with my story titled An Unusual Chapter in Friendship. You know, friendship is something that we learn to respect as we grow older. People like me who are in their 20s, moving into new cities for higher education and career option, could very well understand how important it is for us to have friends, most importantly good and close friends. So before I begin narrating my story, let me give you a brief out about what's going on. So, something is stopping the kids of Arid High School from enjoying together. Will it be the reason for the distance in their friendship? Let's read and find it out. One fine day, the kids of Arid High School, instead of enjoying the Saturday evening, were sitting idle in a corner bench in the park. Jason spoke up. It is getting so hectic nowadays. Continuous tests and assignments and constant pressure to perform well. Sundays also pass by in completing project files. I just hate my life. Yeah, I agree with you. And just think about me, guys. Besides studies, I have a dance class too. And Miss Mary also wants me to perform on every special occasion in the school, along with that crazy Alex, who keeps on stepping my feet throughout the performances. I'm just sick of all this, Ira added up in one breath. Hey friends, we can all go for a picnic to relax and to get ourselves rid of this busy schedule, proposed Adya. Mamit said, I think Adya is right. That would be fun. And we haven't been to anywhere since Christmas. Fine. So tomorrow is Sunday. Maybe we all could take an early morning cycle ride to the valley on the outskirts and have our picnic in our favorite spot, asked Polina. That sounds perfect, the rest of the gang cheered. So let's meet up tomorrow in the morning at my place and we'll go for it, Adya announced, sounding like a perfect team leader. So the following day, the kids met in the morning at Adya's place and left for the valley. Hey, come on guys, speed up. We can see the trend too, Jason said while speeding his ride. And the kids had a race to the valley, with Paulina coming first and Jason last. Yes, that was really fun. They parked their cycles and went near to the big tree under which was their favorite spot. As they were arranging their favorite spot by spreading the seed and taking out some of their packed snacks, chocolates, juices, game boards, they heard the sound of the train. They ran towards the crossing and saw the train going. That filled them with immense happiness, watching the train with the steam coming out and with the crazy sound. They waved hands toward the passenger and the window seats and even got waved back from some too. As they came back under the tree, they found someone sitting on their favorite spot and having their food. Hey, who are you? And this is our spot, yelled Mammy. Oh, I'm really sorry. Actually, I was really hungry and I saw food here and hence I ate it. I'm really sorry, kids. It's okay, sir. You can have it. But who are you and what are you doing here? Asked Adya. Oh, I forgot to introduce myself. Hello, I'm Dr. Craig. I'm a scientist. I live in the uptown. Actually, I was going back to the city from a meeting in the next town and my car got punctured. And that's how I am here, said the man by extending hands for a step towards the kids. Hello, sir. Nice to meet you. I'm Adya. And these are my friends. We came here for a picnic. And I'm really sorry for the trouble, said Adya politely while shaking hands. Actually, kids, I'm also familiar with this place. This used to be my picnic spot too in my childhood along with my friends. We used to come here every alternate Sunday, have some fun, and we really used to have a great time, said Dr. Drake with a drop of tear in his eyes. That's really great. We thought this was our picnic spot alone, said Ira, all excited. So, how are your friends nowadays? Don't you come to picnics anymore? Asked Polina. Actually, that's a long story. As time passed by, we grew old, got busy in our own lives with all taste, project, then career and all. We started having fights. Fights grew bigger and gradually we completely forgot about picnic. And life kind of turned monotonous, replied Dr. Brent with deep pain in his voice. That's really sad, said Adya. Suddenly the kids could realize the gravity of the situation and could somehow sense the bitter truth of the future. Dr. Drake spoke up. Look kids, friendship is the most beautiful gift that life gives us. Don't let it go because of stupid reasons. Test and work would come and go, but friendship once gone is hard to revive. So cherish your friendship every day. Friends are the best part of lives, and it is the moment of your fun that would be a beautiful memory for tomorrow and keep you going on. Anyway, the mechanic must have changed the tire. So I would take a leave from you guys. It was nice meeting you all, and thanks for the food. And a piece of advice. Just be like this as you are today, strong and bonded. Thank you so much, Doctor. That explained a lot to us and cleared our confusion to the answer for which we came today, said Adya. It was nice meeting you, sir, and we hope you to meet your friends someday soon and clear out everything. Wished Mary. Thank you, kids. I hope. Okay, take care. Bye. Dr. Drake said while waving back to the kids as he walked out towards the main highway. There was a long silence. All kept watching as the doctor walked away. Adya broke the silence. So, here we are, a face closer to the future. Do you guys think we might end up like this, all alone? Never. No way. I am not going to leave you guys at all, cried Molina. Yes, no test, no assignment can make us apart, yelled Jason. Mervin said, clearing his voice, I don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, and even do not want to know. Right now, I am with you guys, enjoying the best time of my life. All I can know, nothing can break our hearts. Yes, nothing can break us. Shouted Adya, as if a mark of souvenir that the valley stored within itself that would keep reminding them about their friendship. As the sun started to set, they went for a good walk and set back to go homes. Up somewhere back, the tree was smiling, looking up in the evening sky, watching one more unique episode of friendship. So, that's it, how the story ends. But before ending the video, I would like to just share something. I feel, or you can say believe, that when we all come to this world, we are somehow chained with certain pre-imposed relation. Friendship is the only relation where we have the choice of freedom, the freedom to choose our friends. And I believe that it is the only relation that do not chain us, rather elevate us to some different level. You are lucky if you have friends, and I feel that you are the luckiest if you are in your 60s and still have your childhood friend by your side. Guys, friendship is the most beautiful gift that you can give to yourself. So yeah, that's it. Take care of your friends. And I would like to dedicate this particular story of mine to all my childhood friends whom I left behind while moving into this new city. And most importantly, to true friendship. That's it. Thank you and have a good day.